New from overnight, troopers looking for the driver of a car who hit and killed a woman and took off.
Witnesses say the victim was in the crosswalk when she was hit late last night. It was not far from Walt Disney World. WESH 2 Stewart Moore joins us live this morning along State Road 535. And Stewart, what are troopers telling you this morning?
Well, Jason, they are saying that they are looking for a black Nissan. Take a look right behind me where this actually happened. They say that the woman was crossing the road when that car sped into her and hit and killed her.
Flares and evidence markers show the scene where a young woman was hit and killed by a passing car. Florida Highway Patrol is on the lookout for the car and person responsible for running down a pedestrian crossing the busy south of Popka Vineland Road. Witnesses say the woman was walking along the crosswalk with the signal in her favor when the car ran a red light and hit her.
I tried to work on her to see if I could actually bring her back, and I was on the phone with a 911 at the same time when I was trying to proceed that.
This man administered first aid, but the victim had no pulse. Now FHP is using clues from the scene, like this Nissan emblem, to help track down the driver.
We've got some parts off the vehicle, and we're going to continue the investigation. This time we know it's a black Nissan. But again, the investigation is continuing, and we hope to discover more information from that.
And back here live, you can actually see some of the glass and debris still in the roadway from where that accident happened, or that crash happened overnight. Now, right now, we are still waiting to find out more information about this victim as well. The witness on the scene says that she was a woman in her 20s, appeared to be Asian as well. As soon as we find out more information about where she is from, we will pass that information along to you. And, of course, if you have any information about who this driver may be, you're asked to call FHP. We're live in Orange County. Stewart Moore, WESH 2 News.